great to be here. When I was in the House of Representatives with Representative Paul Tonko of New York, he had a saying, because we were the mechanical engineering caucus, so he would say, it's all about me, M.E. We were proud to be the two members of that caucus in the House, and now he is on his own in the Senate, but, or in the House, but holding up just fine as the only mechanical engineer over there. And I'm trying to carry that banner in the U.S. Senate. We have really seen an incredible amount of change when you think back at the last few years. I recently had an opportunity to climb up one of those huge wind turbines like you see over there against the wall and look out at the grid. And I had an opportunity to just think about how much things have changed from when I was a kid. I grew up in a utility family. My dad was a lineman and a maintenance man for a gas and electric utility. And I'd sit around his office drawing pictures of Ready Kilowatt, and he would tell me how the grid worked and how electricity would go from central generation at some coal-fired power plant or a hydro facility out these huge transmission lines to distribution to homes and businesses that bought that electricity. And we all know that today, that's not how things work anymore. When I looked out from the top of that wind turbine, I saw a grid that is completely different today than what we knew 30 years ago, where electrons flow in multiple directions, where consumers like myself are actually prosumers, producing energy, consuming it, or selling it back to the grid. And much of that progress that we've made has been incremental. Paul and I were both in the House when we tried to pass Matt Waxman-Markey to address carbon pollution. I think sometimes we sell ourselves short for the incredible changes that happened because of things like the Recovery Act, the money that went into storage and innovation and research, the investments that were made in the ITC and the PTC that have driven so much change. I spent over a year working with my colleagues in the Senate to fight for the energy bill that we did at the end of last year to create 7 more years of certainty under the ITC and the PTC so that we can leverage those investments so that we all know that when you make tax policy 1 year at a time, that 1 + 1 + 1 does not equal 3. When you make tax policy for 4, 5, 6, or 7 years, you get dramatically more investment in these technologies than you get when you make it year by year. And by creating that, we saw an outcome in this first quarter, when you look at the FERC report on new generation, that we could not have imagined 10 years ago. I mean, new generation numbers that were 99.2% clean energy. You had 18 new megawatts of natural gas. Everything else was vast new quantities of wind and solar and hydro and biomass. An incredible outcome. That happened because of all of you in this room. This has changed the way we think about energy. And we need to take and pivot to what is next. What are we going to do next to make sure we continue to drive this innovation? And I believe strongly that over the next few years, you're going to see more and more electrification of transportation and a more and more distributed grid, where a lot of the innovation is at the consumer level in terms of what people want. The one common thread there is going to be storage. And so today I'm introducing with Senator Heller of Nevada and a number of my colleagues in the Senate a ITC investment tax credit patterned exactly after what we see for solar right now for storage. For grid-based storage at the utility scale level and the commercial level, patterned exactly after what we saw in Section 48, and then the 25D model applying to people who actually put storage at their homes so that they can have resilience and self-generation. I think we are going to change the way we consume energy in this country faster in the next 5 years than we've seen in the last 30. And it's all because of the innovation in this room that this continues moving forward and continues to create the jobs of tomorrow that we are really relying on as policymakers and as a country. So thank you for all of your work. We look forward to working with all of you. And I look forward to coming back next year and seeing just how much things have changed in a mere 12 months.
Thank you. I just want to say to you, Senator, I've had the opportunity to work with a company in New Mexico called Sacred Power, a Native American-owned company. and there are 1.6 million people on this planet without electricity. This company ships systems with batteries, by the way, for refrigeration, lighting, and communication. And it is, for the first time in history, 2015, there was more investment in the developing world for these blend of technologies than in the developed world. So we are in a changing world. Thank you for your support. Bye-bye. Let's go.